Hey, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and welcome to this week's episode. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to create that soft, dreamy background with this photograph. So we've got a little bit of these little circles going on, which is known as bokeh, but I'm going to make it much more pronounced and much more romantic. So this is the kind of thing that usually would be achieved by using a very shallow depth of field and a very wide open aperture on the camera. So here we get a photograph. First thing we're going to do is we're going to cut these people out. And then there's a little trick I'm going to show you so we don't get the fringing around the edges, which usually happens when you blur the background. And then we're going to create this bokeh effect. So why don't we start off by just cutting them out quickly. And we're going to just use the quick select tool to do that. So we're just going to grab our quick select tool right now and just go around here. And I'm not going to get into all the details of cutting this out. I'm just going to show you how I do it right here. But I have other tutorials that I'll link to you on how to cut out the background where I spend more time on it. So I'm just hitting the Alt key or the Option key, just going around here. I want to make sure we don't get this bit in the middle, just very gently going in there. One of the things here, I'm using a pen. We can go down here. We can turn size to pen pressure if you want it, because I'm using a Wacom pressure-sensitive pen here. And you just have a little bit of trouble getting in there. So what we do is just make it smaller. And that's with the left bracket key, so we can get in there, and it's looking pretty good. So I just want to check my selection here, so I'm just going to hit the Q for quick mask, and that's actually looking not bad at all. And I'm just going to choose a select and mask right now, give it a little bit of radiance just to make it look better, clean it up a little bit. There we go, that's not bad. And then we just want to copy this one out to a new layer with a layer mask. So we're just going to click here. All right, so there we go. We've got them cut out and we can see there's a background. So here's the thing that happens. If I was to just blur this background, I'll show you something here. And this can be a problem a lot of the time when people just do a simple blurring of the background like this. Notice when I do that, see this fringing we get around the edges there? See how it's soft? You can see it's almost like a halo effect or a doubling effect there. And what's happening, that's because these pixels there that we can see are being blurred. You can especially see it there. So that's one of the things we kind of want to avoid that. So I'm just going to hit the cancel right there. And let me just make that fit. All right. So what we can do to eliminate this problem is now that we've created this mask, control click on that mask makes that selection. Now, sometimes I might expand this by a pixel, or what I'm going to do in this case, I'm just going to select modify. And I am going to expand this by 1 pixel. And then I'm going to choose select, modify, and then we're going to feather it by 1 pixel. So this is just creating a softer edge than just that hard edge. And now I'm just going to use content aware fill. Now it doesn't have to be perfect. Let me hide the top layer so you can see it. So I'm going to hit the shift delete on Mac. And that would be shift backspace on Windows to bring up the fill dialog box. Go down, make sure you select content aware. And then just click OK. And it's just going to do a Control D to turn it off. And you can see we've got this kind of ghosting, almost like they're semi-transparent. But that's all we need, just to make sure we don't get those colors around the edges, which are going to bleed in when we blur it later on. All right, so let's turn our layer on top. We're almost there. Now, what we want to do now is we want to create a soft blurred background, but we want to really enhance this bokeh in the back here that comes from the lens, and that gives it that really nice romantic look, and it also makes it look like it was shot with a much more expensive lens. So let's make sure the background is selected, then we're going to choose filter, and then we're going to go down to the filter gallery, well actually the blur gallery. So we're doing this here inside of Photoshop CC. Now, the blur gallery was in CS6, but if you have an earlier version, just use a blur, a Gaussian blur, and you're going to pretty much have to leave it at that. But what we're going to do is we're going to go here, we're going to go to the field blur. So we're going filter, blur gallery, field blur. And this is where we create a depth of field effect by applying two points here. But what we're going to do is we're just going to keep the single point there and just create a blur. So right now we're at about a 15 blur, and we really want to bring these out. So it takes a little bit of practice to kind of play around and get it right. So we're going to move some things around. So we're going to start with light bokeh, and we're just going to move it up a little bit till we start to see some of that bokeh effect. Okay, it's starting to happen, but it's not very clean yet. This is not what we want. So what we're going to do is play around with the light range. Notice as we increase this, this just makes everything kind of blow out, which is kind of cool for certain things, but we don't want to do too much of that. We're going to actually clamp it down here. And so we bring the white in. I'm kind of liking it about there. Let me bring the black a bit more. And sometimes you're going to have these almost on top of each other to get the effect we're looking for. In fact, why don't we just do that right now? And we're going to adjust the amount of blur. Okay, it's not quite happening yet. Let's increase the amount of bokeh. Ah, see, now it's starting to pop. See how we can see these little bits of bokeh are starting to pop now. So let's increase the blur. There we go. And see what we're doing there is we're getting these beautiful, nice kind of like blurred effects. I'm just going to stop it about there. And you can see we've got this nice bokeh. Let's play around a little bit more, maybe increase it a bit more. There we go. That's not bad. And as you can see, we can play around with these settings here. And let's bring that down a little bit. And so what it is now is just really a balancing act of just playing around with the difference between how much bokeh we're going to get, the light range settings here, and make sure that those are pretty much on top of each other to make it work, those two triangles. And then we just play around with the amount of blur there to, you know, get bigger bokeh there or smaller bokeh about there. But now we've got them like just dialed in beautifully. So maybe we're going to go about that size here, maybe down a little bit. There we go. And you can see we've kind of dialed this in right now. Now, the other thing we can do is we can add some color in here and see how that will just add different types of colors. But in this case, we really don't want that because it's not very natural because it's pretty much just one kind going in there. And then we're just going to click OK. And then if we look at this, here's our top layer. When we hide it, there's our background. Notice it's beautiful and seamless because we would use that content-aware fill. Then we drop our couple on there. Notice there's no fringing or anything around there. And voila, so we've been able to create that effect just like that. So if we look at it before and after, you can see how much more dreamy and romantic this photograph is. So I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, hit the subscribe button and become part of the Cafe crew, and I'll give you a new tutorial every single week. Don't forget to hit the like button and also add a comment. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.